through they teeth. Hope you slip up off your path. I don't switch up, I just laugh. Put my kicks up on they desk, unaffected by they threats. Then get busy on they ass. See, that's how that shit tell me.
A very warm welcome to the Sports Arena Sentosa. We're just on the outskirts of Petaling Jaya, Kuala Lumpur. It's the venue for the Purple League 2017-2018. And we're in the opportunity here to get a seeded place in the finals coming up in Genting in a couple of weeks' time. Pucon United, they've already won the title. They're in Group A alongside Ceres and Petaling Jaya. Whoever comes at the top of that particular group will end up as a seeded team when it comes to Genting. That means directly through to the semi-finals. Earlier on today, Petaling won 12-6 in Kepong to give them an opportunity of making it as a seeded team. But Pucon United versus Petaling Jaya, Pucon United, the outstanding team. 7 wins out of 7 for Pucon United.
Petaling Jaya facing a tough time tonight. Petaling Jaya versus Pucon United. But before we begin to see all of the best badminton action, let me introduce to you the players from Petaling Jaya. Representing them in the men's singles category, Labib Muzaffar Rakamagi.
For Petaling Jaya, first up in the singles is a debutant in the Purple League, Labib Muzaffar, ranked number 599 in the world.
Lakamagi.
And for the women's singles,
Lee Ziyi played two, lost two in the regular season. She'll be hoping to at least pick a game up in the second upon court. Thanks, Swan in the women's singles.
In the men's doubles, give it up for Jati Singh Danoa and Rama Chandran.
That is Thiram. We better know him as a singles player. And his first appearance in the doubles is alongside the experienced Jagdeep Singh, third up in the men's doubles.
For the mixed doubles, give your support for Tanesh Birka and Tiwei Chi.
For Tanesh and Tiwei Chi, two young Malaysian players partnering in the mixed doubles, 485 their world ranking.
And representing Petaling Jaya in the men's singles, Go Jiap Chi!
A veteran of the Purple League, this is his 18th match in the Purple League, all for Petaling Jaya. 7 wins, 7 losses, 3 ties for Go Jiap Chi.
Petaling Jaya is coached by Yo K. Loon and Kamaldeep Singh.
Coaching team of K. Loon and Kamaldeep Singh. They will be in the corners throughout, offering words of encouragement.
Lawan mereka adalah pasukan yang dikatakan
tabat untuk muncul Manoj Kumar. Juara.
And the smoothest dude in the Purple League, Manoj Kumar, makes pasukan his way out and a chance for me to introduce our co-commentator for today. Let's have a look at this. Quick thoughts on Petaling Jaya.
Well, they certainly are conserving their strength back here. Petaling Jaya, as we look at their lineup, they will be focusing on the matches on Genting.
Samuel Nessem with the analysis. Lou Darren comes onto the court for Pucon United. World rank number 46. He'll be up against Labib in the first of the men's
singles.
She has no world ranking, Deng Chuan, but she is a former part of the national team in China. And is a very, very good player to watch.
In the doubles category, give your support for Lim Kim Hwa and Mak Hee Chun.
Just inside the world top 100, Lim Kim Hwa. He's always entertaining, and Mak Hee Chun will be a good foil for Lim Kim Hwa in the men's doubles.
For the mixed doubles, Kim Hwa and Wong Wai Chun.
for Jin Suan and Wai Jun. They are two youngsters. That will be an interesting mixed doubles pairing against Stanis and Tiwai Chi on the other side. The highest ranked player. Well, up against Gojab Chen, sorry, he's behind Lu Daran, is he? But he's still inside the world top 50. Lian Sheng is the coach. Puchong United, 7 wins out of 7 in the league. She has guided her team to that perfect record and will not want to lose momentum in this playoff stage. As we have a look at their perfect record, look at that. They started the season with 2 perfect 15-point scores. And from then on, they were virtually unbeatable. Samuel Nesem, Puchong United, the team to beat.
That's indeed the other team to beat. They've only lost 4 matches in their 7 ties in the Samsung Senheng Purple League. Unfortunately, though, 2 of them came from the mixed doubles, and they're fielding a very junior partnership today in the mixed doubles.
This is the partnership that we're going to see. There are 5 matches as usual, each one best of 5 games, first to 11. Lu Daran versus Labib is a big opportunity for Labib, right the way down to Weinan versus Gojab Chin. Quick thoughts on, very quick thoughts on how this might go.
Yeah, this is going to be one-way traffic. Puchong, I'm afraid, has hit to this one.
Okay, let's go down to Dayang Zainatul. She is talking to the respective team managers.
Kita dengar apa kata pengenali kedua pasukan. Silakan, Dayang.
Hey guys, welcome back to the SSPL 2017-2018. Stage 2 is tonight and we will be seeing Petaling Jaya take on Puchong United. A very, very exciting night indeed for both teams and for all of us who have been following the SSPL 2017-2018 since day one. With me, we have the two team managers from both of the teams, and I'm pretty sure a lot of Petaling Jaya supporters are wondering about the lineup for tonight. The last time you met Puchong United, you had a, I could say, a better lineup, and you lost. So tonight, what's the plan?
Actually, we didn't plan much because most of the players are away for tournaments and they are back to their country, preparing for the Thomas Uber Cup and Asian Team Championship. So this time lineup, I just put my second lineup to play with Puchong United.
With this lineup being sent by Petaling Jaya, is this an added advantage for Puchong United?
Well, we are currently at the number one spot. So for these upcoming 2 matches, is enough for us to take 9 points, 9 sets, to be on the to remain on the top of the table. However, this lineup, what we presented today, we input the new mixed double pair, which is young, talented junior players, and I think we get ourselves that advantage that we can fully and for the, freely to use them in the upcoming matches, and then they will also won't have pressure, and we need to get the best performance from them because this is their chance to grow. And
yeah, I'm pretty sure that a lot of people were wondering about your mixed doubles also today, because a lot of people have been watching how Puchong United have presented their players during this whole season. Okay, but going back to Petaling Jaya, also a very interesting fact here is that you are putting a singles players into the doubles. Satish Taran, how did that happen?
Actually, Satish, lately he has played mixed doubles and double matches. And I think he can play doubles. So, and I let my second single, Labib, he's an upcoming junior player from my club. So I put him to play single and I put Satish to play doubles.
Sometimes something tells me that Petaling Jaya are just keeping their best players for surprises in Genting later on. Okay, so for Puchong United, Lu Daran, he has sort of, I could say, experienced a psychological boost, and we have seen that that was very, very apparent, especially in the Malaysian Masters Open. So will that still be presented tonight by him?
Well, I believe that all the matches before, I always was saying about the focus and each game, even from the first game to the last. I think this amazing performance on the recent 2 tournaments is also, we believe, came from our matches as well. That's the victory don't come overnight. It's a long preparation. And that's what I always say, they have to keep going regardless of the opponent. and only you can achieve the great performance when it's important.
Indeed, I agree with you very, very much. Okay, so thank you very much for your time today. Let's shake hands to show good sportsmanship. The very best of luck to both Petaling Jaya and Puchong United. We will be going back to our commentators.
Thank you, Dayang. Yes, that's baik, not the commentators,
kasih, Dayang,
it's the fans.
Tadi,
but we're up high in the
apa yang,
top end of the sports arena, Sentosa, getting ready for a men's singles, which Kuma sees Lou Darum. Would you believe he's now got 16 matches under his belt?
And just one defeat. In the men's singles, our umpire is John Yujin and the service judge is Lim Ho-Wa.
Everybody on their phones ahead of the match as the service judge and the main judge are introduced out onto the court. And then Dayang will introduce the players.
Jadi cerita untuk pusingan yang kedua ini,
mereka tidak mahu
mengurangkan kekuatan sambil Manoj Kumar dan juga anak buahnya bagi pasukan Petaling Jaya BC.
One of the reasons the Purple League was invented to give opportunities to the likes of Labi just inside the world top 600. He's up against the world top 50 player.
Berdasarkan pemain-pemain yang diturunkan,
representing
Puchong
United, give it up for Liu Darren.
Had a terrific Malaysia Masters. Lou Darren is at the top of his form in the world's top 50. And as I said, looking back at the Purple League stats, just one defeat in 16 matches, nine ties in there. Six ties and nine victories. He doesn't lose very often in this form of the game.
80%.
Well, indeed, he hasn't lost in this season. Samsung Sentling Purple League played seven. He's, of course, been on a streak of three straight draws, Liu Darren. And he looked on the verge of defeat in his last match against Yan Dun Zhu. But what a psychological advantage he's had coming from behind to win that. I honestly think that's what boosted him in the Malaysian Masters.
Here he is, world ranked number 46, 30 years of age now, a free agent. And yeah, Arena said in the pre-match that form in this Purple League, if you're playing regularly under competition with major points to play, it can transfer itself onto the international stage.
It certainly can, especially with players that sometimes can struggle psychologically, like Liu Darren. It's worked positively for him and certainly producing results.
As for Labib on the other side of the net, the Sabahan is still a teenager. And this will be probably the biggest match of his fledgling career. And an opportunity just to see if he's got the temperament and the game to match one of the big guns.
Yeah, of course, this is his baptism of fire for him.
Memang tugasnya saya katakan berat kerana berdasarkan performance ataupun
made the quarterfinals of the Egypt international series last year. Labib, and he'll be hoping to win a game or two of Liu Darren.
Dia dikatakan antara nama-nama yang sedang diberikan serius oleh BM untuk dibawa dalam Thomas yang akan turun dalam saingan acara berpasukan Asia di Alasan
nanti. Rather more sedate and conservative all-blue of Puchong United. And sedate and conservative has been the way for Puchong. Played seven, won seven. As you say, Lou Darren has played in all seven of those ties, unbeaten. Although three of them have been draws. That's what you can get in this Purple League. You can get drawn matches because there's a clock, 30 minutes maximum per match. Plus you've got the number of pressure points. When you reach 10-all, there's an automatic game-deciding point. So plenty of innovation in the Purple League, and it's now
peringkat awal ini mungkin tidak akan berlaku, tetapi mungkin keputusan di Alor Star nanti akan berpengaruh kepada
Samuel. Obviously, you're going to go for Lou Darren, but is Labib good enough to pick up a win, a game?
Lou Darren. I think that sometimes Lou Darren does lack, especially after if he wins the first two games, he can lack a little bit, and that's where Labib will be hoping to catch him off guard. So possibly one point.
Gentlemen, Omarai, Puchong Jatuh PC, dibentuk by Liu Darren.
Masa itu kami keputusan untuk keluar daripada BM untuk bergerak secara profesional, secara solo.
Petaling Jaya BC dipimpin oleh Rabit Muzaffar.
Kebangkitan yang ditampilkan sejak kebelakangan ini. Saya rasa impact kepada Purple League ini juga membawa kepada persembahan yang baik Liu Darren pada saingan Malaysia Masters.
Ya, mungkin juga kerana kita lihat permainan beliau boleh dikatakan seolah-olah matang kembali. Dia sudah mendapat sentuhan-sentuhan seperti kebangkitan dia ketika memenangi France Super Series.
Nice long rally for Labib to get off to a nice start.
That's exactly what he needs to settle the nerves, the youngster.
One point at a time.
selagi menggunakan format 30 minit, kedua pemain perlu menamatkan saingan. Keluar. Untuk mata yang kedua.
He'd like to finish the game here and now, I suspect.
Awal saingan masing-masing masih lagi mencari tempo dan juga rentak permainan sebenar.
Very tight net play from Ludaro.
Must be intimidating to see Liu Dan and charging so close to the net.
Lin melihat Lin terlibat secara langsung pada Malaysian Masters baru-baru ini.
Of course, the net area is where Liu Dan is strongest.
Poin penting sebenarnya pada kebangkitan Liu Dan ini.
Saya melihat beliau lebih tenang sebenarnya dalam permainan, corak permainan beliau. Beliau tidaklah terlalu terburu-buru.
Gentlest of touches drops in.
Dia lebih kepada ketenangan sebenarnya dalam permainan beliau. Dan juga beliau sudah semestinya fokus tumpuan memang dekat situ jelas yang saya nampak yang dia berikan dalam setiap permainan atau game yang beliau lalui.
Just clips the top of the net for the second time.
3-2.
There's an air of confidence about Liu Darren's game.
Kedua.
Well, he's every right to feel that way. Took off the former world number one, Sean Wonho, last week.
Service all. 3-4.
Early skirmishes. Still all square.
Permainan yang saya katakan lebih berkisar kepada permainan di jaring pada ketika ini, pada kedudukan tiga sama.
Pushed a little bit long by Labib.
4-3.
Trails for the first time.
Smash.
Very clever lift by Liu Darren.
Three.
Just at a right angle to force an error from Labib.
That one a long way out, Darren.
Very loose lift and good escape for Labib.
Kesilapan.
Service all.
Mudah.
Six.
I think he's hit his finger there. That serve.
Nampak.
It's a first for us this season. Drops it out, a good lead from Darren.
Double mines,
four in double quick time.
Yeah, and this is in the mid stages, is where Liu Darren likes to surge ahead.
Oh, bijak kali ini dari
pick up, but an easy smash from Labib.
Bagaimana bola tanggung itu?
What a cheap giveaway from the
sekencang
from a top 10 player in the world, Liu Darren.
Dimatikan untuk memberikan mata yang kelima.
Nice
kali ini dari Liu
Darren. Posted stamp corner.
Well, if there's one area you want to avoid when playing Liu Darren, it's that forehand side.
Pengawalan gelanggang yang agak sedikit longgar ditampilkan oleh pemain muda dari negeri Sabah ini. Untuk dia ketinggalan tiga mata di belakang Liu Darren.
Didn't catch that one right, but in control of the rally up until that point, Darren.
Early stages of the
perhatikan juga sekarang Lin sudah kedua-duanya mengelak untuk bermain di jaring.
Another one that's gone wide from a good position.
Saja keluar.
12 of them in total from both sides.
Lurus yang dilakukan oleh Liu Darren.
Walaupun idea ataupun posisi kosong itu pantas.
Still expecting him to go on, but
he's
not making it easy. Push long.
Lagi tolakkan ke belakang dari
coming towards Labib as he hits his shot, and it's surprising that that went long.
Judgment yang cukup baik dari Liu Darren.
9-7. Well played by Labib. Pounced onto that tight net shot.
An encouraging clap from the youngster. He senses an opportunity here as he goes to the business end of this game.
He's not far from getting this back on, Darren.
Bola tanggung sebenarnya. Mudah untuk Zafar
beautifully dropped.
Dan cantik kali ini dari Liu Darren. Untuk game point bagi Liu Darren.
From Liu Darren right in the front.
Pada aksi yang sudah berlanjutan
this game point for one 7
menit setakat ini. Tamat belum. Untuk 11.
Valiant battle by Labib.
Won by Wuchong Datuk BC.
11. Bagi
as we look at that final point, that air of confidence we were talking about earlier, when he came through, that Liu Darren knew that he could inject pressure
pertama.
When he wanted to. Fully finished off that first game.
It's quite interesting that Lee and Chung, the coaching staff for Puchong United BC, is actually indicating to Darren not to take it too easy.
And as we look at this first shot chart for Liu Darren, that seems to be the case. 8 and 4 errors in that first game, only 3 winners. One of them, of course, that's straight down the line smash.
Mungkin dia bersetuju. Banyak berkisar di pemain yang dijaring.
Stats courtesy are very hard-working statisticians from the Magic.
Jelas kelihatan.
Apakah dia akan bertahan untuk Muzaffar di set yang kedua?
Kerana
seperti kebiasaan selepas mendapat tempo permainan yang sebenar, Liu Darren akan datang dengan pelbagai variasi serangan. Ali.
Itulah yang selalu dilakukan oleh.
And the net play looks so casual.
A lot of spin in it from Liu Darren.
1-0. Did service dari Liu Darren.
Darren, did he catch his arm there?
One.
I have a feeling he didn't.
Well, twice already.
Oh.
A lot of ferociousness from Liu Darren as he closed out that point.
Mau segera mengembalikan keyakinan untuk terus memimpin perlawanan ini pada angka 21. Tak lepas.
Labib a little bit tentative. You can almost see it as he approached the shuttle.
He's struggling with his nerves there. He totally mishit that first smash, Labib.
Too tight.
I suspect that Labib has got to try playing the net shots a little bit faster. He's giving far too much time for Liu Darren to play the spin net in front.
Pemain muda ini.
Nice cross court. Hardly perspiring, and we had a shot there for Labib. He is absolutely dripping already.
And that's a lot of it due to what Liu Darren did in that first game. He gave a lot of opportunities for Labib to attack. He himself has not quite got into the attacking game just yet, Liu Darren.
Labib wide.
Six.
And Posera.
This second game is getting away from Labib.
He senses that he's got to place it further wide if he's going to get a point of Liu Darren.
Posera 7 untuk Liu Darren.
It's good. 7-1.
7-1.
7-1.
Very tentative lift by Labib, but what a put away from Liu Darren.
Saya wawarkan di awal saingan set yang kedua. Memberikan ruang kepada Liu Darren untuk main secara menyerang.
Benefits Maneko, but the flat serve, the flick serve.
8-1.
Had the elements of surprise.
Well, the speed in this game is rapidly changed in contrast to that first game, and you can see what it's doing to the.
Ikutnya 2 minit boleh.
8-1.
9.
Lagi mata untuk Liu Darren. 9-1.
Coming in quick succession, isn't it?
Not been a rally worthy of the name in this second game. That's quality.
It is in a blink of an eye.
Game point
opportunity
for Liu Darren.
More magic. Forehand, backhand, beautiful stuff from Liu Darren.
11. Cross dijaring oleh Liu Darren.
He was in a hurry in that second game, Liu Darren. Only needing 3 minutes and actually less than it.
Kayak dia tetap sana, kayak, okay.
fair enough to say he didn't take it too easy that time.
Certainly heeded the Li Yansheng's request there to not take his opponent too easy. And this is what we see the big gap here.
Confident makin main, ha. Kau tak boleh push, tak apa. Tinggi-tinggi kasih pun tak apa, biar, ha. Satu-satu main tak apa, ha. Confident main.
Confident main.
Far less unforced errors from Liu Darren, only three in his time. In total contrast to the first game, it's eight winners and three unforced errors.
Third game.
Kiri dan kanan.
Love all.
Labid Muzaf.
Play.
Tiga bermula.
Beautiful cross court from Liu Darren. Nonchalant brilliance.
He's starting off in the same way he did in the previous game.
That's beautifully played by Labib.
It's quite encouraging to see the coaching staff of BJBC just telling Labib to enjoy his game.
There are 1 point at a time.
Tries to blame the racket.
Untuk berdepan dengan Liu Darren di set yang ketiga.
Getting his timing wrong there in the smashes, Labib. It's not for the first time.
Kerana short chart sebentar tadi menyaksikan di set yang kedua.
Liu Darren maybe got a point to prove here about being
kiri dan
Thomas
kanan
Cup
menjadi sasaran utama Liu Darren.
I think he certainly would, especially with the result last week.
Smash yang dilakukan oleh Liu Darren.
Defeated the former world number one, Son Wanho.
Lovely overhead from Darren, 3-1.
Harus diberikan.
That 4.
4-1.
He's on the roll today. Remember, of course, the last match he played before coming to this one was against Victor Axelsen, the current world number one. Plenty of exposure.
Big smash. We ought to tell him there's a traffic jam outside. So he doesn't want to leave too early, Darren.
He certainly seems as if he's in a hurry.
Untuk menjaga pukulannya ini dilakukan.
There's very little that Labib can do with the pace in which Liu Darren is approaching this game.
Shot. Little bit too easy.
He's almost half-hearted that time, Liu Darren in the smash. But this is, of course, his more lethal side at forehand side. This time going cross-court, Liu Darren.
Mata-mata yang diperolehi oleh Labib adalah kesilapan daripada Liu Darren.
Barely 11 and a half minutes. And we're closing in on a three games victory. Labib couldn't get low enough.
Pas pula.
Tahan yang baik dari Liu Darren, 7-2.
Enjoy the experience. Take out of it whatever you can.
Baru 12 minit mereka beraksi di set yang ketiga secara keseluruhannya.
Sometimes in this kind of situation, as a player, you feel good that the shot didn't go away. It's much better than getting a hit down at your face.
Oh, it's gone long. He didn't know that. Flailed the racket.
Well, I usually say that Liu Darren tends to slow down. The third game, he certainly hasn't today.
Makin menjarakkan kedudukan untuk Liu Darren. Menjarakkan pungutan mata untuk menuju ke angka 11.
Three errors he's made there, just pulling a little bit too much.
Well, I counted four actually, but regardless, it shows that he's making quite a number of errors from that shot.
10-an false error untuk Liu Darren.
But not many from that lovely little deception. Match point.
10-4.
Match point 4.
Untuk match point bagi Liu Darren.
Game.
Darren takes it, straight games like shelling peas.
11-8, 11-1, 11-4.
Quick action from Liu Darren. Didn't seem like it in the first game.
Cukup pantas.
In this last game, he's really close. They saw the breakneck speed.
Ditunjukkan oleh Liu Darren. Sebenarnya ini sedikit sebanyak memberikan satu pengalaman kepada Labib.
11-8, 11-1, 11-4. And after that tight first set in which Labib got off to a good start, it was then the power, the finesse, the confidence, just about everything good about Liu Darren.
Certainly was, and gave Labib a lot of opportunities to attack. So in that sense, Labib perhaps felt frustrated in his inability to penetrate Liu Darren's defense. And that's when Liu Darren took a psychological advantage over his opponent in the second and third games, attacking his way through. We're going to have a few examples of that here. He actually punched those shots deep into the back, giving himself a lot of room here. This time,
baik dunia.
Setting it up with a brilliant net shot.
Terlalu gemetar untuk bermain dengan Liu Darren.
Control shots that we saw from Liu Darren. And when the opportunity presented itself, that lethal forehand smash.
Bagaimana pengawalan gelanggang secara totalnya.
Well, there's not more you can do better than that in terms of a front court winners, 11-6 at the rear court, 11 consecutive points at one time. Maybe he wants to cut out the unforced errors, but that's pretty good from Liu Darren. As expected, he's beaten Labib in straight games. Coming up next, the women's singles, and Deng Swan is another strong contender for Puchong United. She's up against another youngster, Lizzie Yee. That's coming up next in the Purple League.
We gon' party like
Purple League comes back to you from the Sports Arena Sentosa. Puchong United off to a great start. Liu Darren beating Labib by 3-0. Coming up next, we have got the women's singles.
Lizzie Yee
up against Deng Shuang. Players about to be introduced onto the court by our MC and host, Ben Zainato.
Minggu ini adalah minggu terakhir dilangsungkan di
Sports Arena sebelum mereka Petaling Jaya
berada di Genting Highland.
The teenager Lizzie Yee, this is her third appearance of the season. Two defeats, but a fighting 1-3 reverse last time round for the teenager.
And representing Puchong United, Deng Shuang.
As for China-born Deng Shuang, well, there's no official world ranking for Deng Shuang, but she has got vast amounts of experience in the game and has, with a 1-1 record this year, perhaps disappointed, but is certainly expecting to pick up maximum points here today.
Certainly it will be for Deng Shuang, even the one defeat she had that was against Guo Jinwei, and very closely, Guo Jinwei, perhaps you might argue, was saved by the clock.
White, blue, your choice.
Deng Shuang.
White. You want the toss, what do you choose?
Permainan yang meyakinkan.
Which cards?
That card. Pada saingan sebelum ini.
thoughts on this one?
I certainly think that Deng Xuan is the favorite to win this one, but sometimes we have seen that she has a tendency to commit a lot of unforced errors, Deng Xuan, and perhaps her opponent today, who stole a point against Ho Yan Mei, may just steal one off Deng Xuan. So my personal prediction for this one, either a 3-0 or 3-1 victory in favor of Puchong's Deng Xuan.
She is from Guangzhou, a left-hander, moves beautifully around the court, very, very graceful mover, but perhaps not the quickest, not the sharpest, particularly getting down and when the shuttle is at her feet. Sorry, she's not a teenager anymore. They all just look like teenagers these days to me. 21 years of age now, Li Ziyi. Comes from a very impressive badminton family, the young Kedahan. How far can you see this girl going?
Certainly, she's still young at 21. Can go the distance. Sometimes players appear to, in the women's singles especially, improve in quick speed. We've seen that from Carolina Marin from nowhere becoming world champion. As well with Nozomi Okuhara. So certainly a lot of potential. Just needs hanging down, perhaps produce the results when needed to. This will be a good opportunity for her to do so.
Lost 3-1 out last time to Ho Yan Mei. Still got heavy strapping on that left knee. Always concerns me. Sometimes it looks an awful lot worse than it is. It's just the wear and tear of constantly putting a hard pressure on those joints. But if you're wearing a knee brace like that, means there must be something just a little bit wrong as he stretches and make sure everything is right.
Sometimes as well, it could be precautionary, as these players tend to do, especially if they're on the recovery after an injury, so they tend to put the strapping on. I personally think for Lee Zijia, it's a bit of caution there. She doesn't want to strain that left knee.
Sementara lawannya, Lee Ziyi.
Ready? Saw strappings like this in Sonia Cha as well.
Ladies and gentlemen, on my right, Petaling Jaya BC, represented by Li
Ziyi.
And on my left, Puchong United BC, represented by Teng Xuan. Petaling Jaya BC to serve. Lebol, play.
Mula bermain badminton secara serius pada usia 11 tahun. Bawa masuk ke dalam skor
pemain sahaja. It's out wide from Li Ziyi.
So it's over.
Kick off very positive.
One love.
Dia pernah muncul juara dalam saingan Grand Prix kebangsaan bawah 14 tahun. Impian dan cita-cita dia melakukan 10 terbaik dunia. Itu mungkin boleh direalisasikan. Fokus akan terus diberikan oleh Li Ziyi. Baik, satu sama.
That's that one drop over her shoulder. It was tight, but a good judgment from Deng.
2-1.
Li Ziyi, very good opportunity to finish that off. Perhaps should have gone for the tap.
Rangkap Deng Xuan.
And then wayward. The net error followed by
four.
Wayward
up dari Li Ziyi.
Shot down the line.
Deng Xuan usually a slow starter. Today, moving up quite quickly.
Another one she judges just perfectly.
Ini di bahagian belakang.
5-1.
Oh, lovely.
Ini cantik.
That's the quality that she can drop. Just turn on.
Dilakukan oleh Deng Xuan.
Sometimes Deng Xuan tends to win more points off those drop shots than she does with the big smashes.
Baik kali ini.
Short and again, she's a little tentative. Am I seeing her movement a little bit?
Badan yang memerangkap.
I don't know. Tentative is the word I used.
That certainly seems to be the case. Yeah, she's very cautious in applying pressure on that left knee.
Tak pas pula.
The word cautious.
8-1.
This has raced away from Lizzie's. Yeah.
the trend with the Puchong players today, especially with Liu Darren's first men's singles match.
Bolt.
That's better. Into the body, then can't react.
She can cut down the errors, Li Ziyi. She's a lot more opportunities to close this gap.
Beautifully punched into the corner.
Nine, two.
An answer to everything that Li threw out of there, did Deng.
Deep in the back.
Game point.
Trying to get the shuttle deeper to Deng Chuan's back.
Langsung.
Game point.
Ketika ini dikedudukan game point, saya rasa Deng Chuan mau untuk terus.
That's a nice shot from Li. Maybe we'll give her a bit of confidence that seems to be lacking.
Yang jelas kita dapat lihat.
That will help too.
Zee di depan, tapi tersangkut jaring.
She perhaps senses that she's lost this game, Li Ziyi. She wants to try and get her shots right as she gets into that second game.
Fault.
And is really battling back.
Five.
Three in a row, her best spell in the game.
Dilakukan oleh Deng Chuan.
Yeah, this is what she needs to be doing, keeping the rallies longer. Looking for opportunities when they present themselves.
Oh, made the late decision. The
first game,
slight gust pushes it back into the court.
Bagian belakang seperti tadi.
11-5 the first game to Puchong.
Mungkin
peringkat
awal
at this point
dapat dikatakan
is going to cost you.
Beberapa kedudukan yang saya katakan 50-50 untuk Li sama ada mau melakukan permainan berbahagian depan ataupun menolak untuk ke belakang. Dia teragak agak untuk membuat keputusan.
Itulah kalau dilihat kedudukan sebegitu yang berlaku kepada beliau.
Ian Chang of course instructing Deng Chuan that
pukulan teragak-agak
not to be too lax, not to slow down her speed, which she has done in that first game. Also telling her to be cautious of the drift that will be affecting the game in the second game. Apart from that, it's been a very surgical performance from Deng Chuan in that first game, clinical in closing out those big shots, those big points.
Kebatasan.
It was quite positive that Li Ziyi tried to bounce back towards the end of the game in spite of that.
Unforced error begitu banyak.
Eight unforced errors in that first game from Deng Chuan.
Second game.
Three push long.
Level.
8 unforced error yang dilakukan oleh
surgical. I like that one.
5 minit diperlukan Deng Chuan untuk set yang pertama. Keluar.
Wide from Li.
One.
Meyakinkan diri sendiri untuk Li Ziyi. Berdasarkan ranking, tidaklah berada dalam kedudukan yang baik secara keseluruhan di peringkat antarabangsa. Oh, cantik kali ini. Overhead yang dilakukan oleh Li Ziyi.
Rally's gone. Oh, the sense that perhaps Li Ziyi has more opportunities.
Satu sama.
Deng rather scooped at that one rather than played it. The end result in the net.
Well, to be fair to her today, this is only her second unforced error in the entire match, Deng Chuan.
And there's number three. Quickly follows.
Three, one.
Puchong United have been absolutely brilliant in the women's singles. They've only lost once this entire campaign this year, this season.
Four-one
for Li Ziyi. then the drift affects this end of the court.
It certainly is, and just suspect that Ding Xuan is perhaps playing those shots without any intent of closing them out.
Oh, bite, tiny.
Again, drops it short, and that's where Deng routinely suffers.
Betul,
Lizzy Yee has cut down on her unforced errors.
Sampai betul di hadapan Deng Xuan yang gagal untuk sedikit menggerakkan
dividends for her.
Badannya untuk
service over 2-5.
25 dengan berikan ruang kepada Deng Xuan untuk menekan, khususnya pada pukulan-pukulan smash dan juga ke belakang yang gemar digunakan pada saingan set yang pertama.
Wow. Service over 6-2.
Now it's complete reverse from the first game.
6-2.
And the drift at that end of the court. Defending the far end.
Great defensive work.
Oh, sayang.
And gets the point.
Walaupun kalau kita perhatikan,
this is where the unforced error seems to be cut down for Deng Xuan.
Dizzy sedikit.
It's a good opportunity.
Tidak memihak kepadanya.
No need to hurry and kill off the chop.
Mungkin option yang dia ada adalah bermain di bahagian depan untuk Deng Xuan. 28. Pass.
That was better. That so one was dropped at the feet of Lee.
Liao untuk melakukan cross net.
It's a much better performance from Lee Ziyi. For fluid in movement as well.
Slight breeze pushes us long again.
Peningkatan yang agak baik ditampilkan oleh Lee Ziyi.
Good response this from Lee Ziyi.
Di set yang kedua ini pada kedudukan ataupun angka 9-3.
That one's good.
Service over 4-9.
Got the judgment wrong this time, the Malaysian.
Simau terus mengejar. 5 mata dicari untuk menyamakan kedudukan.
Pas pula.
5-9.
Ding Xuan has every capability of coming back in this game.
Yeah, you suspect these next 2 points, if they go her way, and the first one has
9,
might cause a little heart palpitation or two for.
Nampak sedikit terikut untuk mau mengikut rentak permainan Deng Xuan setakat ini. Pada ketika pungutan mata mula dikolehi oleh Deng Xuan.
She's pulled that one. That was the opportunity.
10, game point 6.
Certainly would have been a great point for her if she's able to keep it in the line. Think so.
She pushes another wide, and the game suddenly disappears.
11-6, one game all.
Well, that was a changeabout.
It certainly was. It all goes down to the unforced errors.
Sedikit memperlahankan, tidak seperti
from
Okay.
11-6. Element of surprise, although there we go.
must be gale force wind from this end, versus Max.
One love.
Indeed, every player in the, I mean, both players who played on this side have trouble controlling their shots.
Two love.
Of course, the other thing to point out was that there was very little intent in the shots of Deng Son in the previous game.
Oh, baik kali
shot. Ini. Drops it right at the feet.
Belakang, kemudian sedikit tap di bagian depan.
Over the net. And this is what we'd expect from a player of caliber. It's that one drift wide.
Four love.
Quite convinced it's the court side. These players are playing it.
Faults.
Indeed, the women tend to give the shuttle that much more air that there's the opportunity for it to be carried literally in the wind. Yeah, and that's a great point because the women's singles, they tend to lift it way higher up than they do in the men's singles. I mean, any of the doubles categories for the matter. Oh. What a remarkable point. Firstly, what a reaction from Deng Xuan to save the one that tickled the top of the tape.
Six love.
Great defense from Li Ziyi. Got two of those three shots back. Six love, though. Lovely shot. Drops it just over the net.
One.
She looked like they're in all sorts of trouble. Easy, even that shot had passed her. Clipped it down with an amazing angle.
Good rally.
One
by Li Ziyi.
As the rally progresses,
the
commit the error is greater. The chances of them coming from Deng Xuan are greater. That's exactly what Li Ziyi is doing. Focusing a lot of those
lifts to the
right-hand side of Deng Xuan.
Hampir kesemua posisi gelanggang ini digunakan oleh Deng Xuan untuk mengasak Ziyi pada ketika ini.
Well, that's a rarity. A shuttle come long at this end of the court.
3-6.
Well, three in a row now for Li Ziyi. After a six love start.
Seven.
3. Kesilapan dari Ziyi. Dari depan jaring.
Seems to have adjusted to the drift quite well in this game, Li Ziyi.
Oh, bola dari Ziyi tolakkan ke belakang untuk mata ke-8.
8-3.
There's no rallies going on at the moment. Must be frustrating to be the coach for both players.
One drops in, Deng.
So it's over.
A little raised eyebrow at the line judge there. Quizzical little look.
Pass.
So it's over. 10.
She's playing a lot of these shots before Deng Xuan. And that, of course, compromises the accuracy of her shots.
Game point for 2-1.
Hampir sama, Lin, kalau kita lihat corak permainan di set yang ketiga dengan set yang pertama untuk Deng Xuan. Baik.
And at the midpoint of the game.
It's a 2-1 lead for them.
The amount of disguise that went into that last shot by Deng Xuan. Look at it here. It looked like it was going to be a lob or a clear. Drop shot that came down.
So 3-1 side of game so far.
4 minutes saja.
Well, as we look at the highlights of the third game, Deng Xuan of course counted well. Sixth consecutive point for her. But
was just unable to carry on in that momentum. Credit to Malaysian Lee Zi Yi, who managed to back at home moment, thought that she was able to control the drift. Lee Zi Yi, very quickly those errors crept in quick succession.
Lawannya,
as quickly as Ding Chuan had gone ahead, she quickly closed out that
tidak ada masa untuk bermain secara perlahan kerana tolakkan ke belakang kemudian mengalihkan bahagian kiri dan kanan depan
jari.
Kemudian kemudian Deng Chuan, itu yang menjadi intipati utama kepada kebangkitan Deng Chuan di set
game underway. Fu Chong this near end through Deng Chuan. Looking good. Now the long rallies tend to go to Lee.
There's so much more intent. I keep using this word because there seems to be a plan in the game of Lee Zi Yi, where she's putting the shots for a purpose, hoping to get a winner.
Karena pukulan itu tidak dapat dikembalikan oleh Zi Yi dari Deng Chuan, tetapi bijak. Ini
Sarasova 1-0.
Untuk pergerakan di bahagian depan dari kedua pemain.
Deng Chuan knows a way around in front as well. Very delicate with those cross-court shots.
Sarasova
2-1. I wonder if the court here is going to affect the performance of Deng Chuan. It's affected every player that has played in this court from in the women's singles.
Slap too far.
Sarasova 2-0.
Sama. Siapa yang akan memulakan persaingan?
Just dropped in. You're watching the Purple League. Sponsored by Sanheng and Samsung. It's the fourth season of the Purple League.
Lebih efisien
sebenarnya. These are the placing matches, but placing matches with a difference in that the reward is possibly see the berth in the Resorts World Genting Purple League finals in a couple of weeks' time. If you are a seeded team, you go straight to the semi-final. On the day before, but more about that later as Deng Chuan continues on the defensive this time.
I'm impressed with the way that Lee Zi Yi has been playing in this game. Been very patient in waiting for the opportunities, but quite clinical in closing them off as well.
Ah, tried a little bit of skullduggery and paid the ultimate price.
Deng Chuan is quite dangerous in front of the court, and Lee Zi Yi did well to get it behind
untuk kedudukan
as soon as possible.
Kembali terikat dengan 4 sama.
Still a lot of power coming down from the racket of Deng Chuan. Perhaps that's one reason why Lee Zi Yi is able to get a lot of these shots back with ease. Fortunately for the Malaysian, it didn't come over the net.
Which is the point of the game, to be fair.
Pada ketiga tim. Cuma naik ketiga, Petaling Jaya diisi kosong. Ini merupakan perlawanan yang kedua. Lepas Liu Darren.
Sebagai
pemain persorangan yang pertama.
5-0.
11 minit yang tinggal untuk kedua pemain memperagakan aksi untuk mencari kemenangan bagi pasukan masing-masing.
Zi Yi, the other hand, hoping to create an upset.
Oh, baik kali ini cross court yang dilakukan oleh Deng Chuan.
Sarasova
hanya memerhatikan saja dari Zi.
Sometimes see moments of brilliance like this from Deng Chuan.
Bola daripada tekanan di bahagian belakang, kemudian return.
Pantas. Just often doesn't get to pull them together to get a consistent run of points.
untuk kedudukan 6-5. Keluar pula.
Drop at her feet and
25.
Out.
7-5.
A 2-point lead. Can't react. Good power from Lee Ziyip.
Sarisova. 6-7.
Well, this thing to the 3-point lead could have been dangerous for Lee Ziyip.
Oh, to get one back. And return dari Deng Chuan.